Probably the number one question that people ask about the western snowy plover is, you mean they just nest right on the beach? They put their nest right on the beach? And we say, yeah, they do. This is how they've done it for thousands of years. They'll put their nest right on the sand, and then for the next month or so, about 28 days, the male and the female will take turns incubating. Once those eggs have hatched, and within a few hours, they're up and running around. That is the young chicks. They're precocial, meaning that they're able to get up, run around. And at that point, it's up to dad to take care of these chicks. Often the female will then leave and find another mate shortly after the chicks hatch. So the male will then take these young chicks, lead them around, show them where to feed, what to feed, and help them keep them out of danger.
The first few weeks of a plover's life are fraught with peril. Predators abound on the California coastline and the near shore areas.
Here on the beach, we have a number of predators, including coyotes, skunks, foxes, ravens, falcons, gulls, anything really that's going to eat an egg or a young chick. So their first few days, first few weeks of life are incredibly tough, and that's when we often lose most of our chicks.
The snowy plovers at Point Reyes National Seashore have been raising their young under the threat of predation since they began nesting there many thousands of years ago. They have evolved with these native predators, and they have adapted several strategies for survival. One such strategy is to color their eggs to look like beach pebbles. However, the recent arrival of a new species on the California coast has introduced new threats to the plover's survival that they are ill-equipped to deal with.
For thousands of years, the snowy plover has nested and bred right on the beaches, and they've been able to do this very successfully. As we've come along, us bipeds, humans, we've used the beach for our own recreation, we've used it for development, we've brought in our pets, and just being on the beach has attracted other predators, which makes it really tough on the snowy plovers for many different reasons. Predation, habitat loss, as well as habitat destruction.
One of the reasons for the destruction of plover habitat comes from the rapid spread of European beach grass along California's coast. This foreign species was introduced to California in the 19th century in order to control the coastal sand dunes along roads and highways. Since then, the European beach grass has overgrown many dunes, limiting the plover's breeding areas to the most exposed and potentially more dangerous stretches of open beach. In 1993, with less than 1,000 birds known to be in existence, the western snowy plover was listed as a threatened species by the Fish and Wildlife Service. If their nesting habitat continues to suffer from human encroachment and non-native species like the European beach grass, then the plovers may disappear entirely.
We get asked quite frequently, not only myself when I'm out on the beaches, but our volunteers, well, why is this important if this one little bird doesn't make it? What happens if it becomes extinct? And there's a couple of things we can say is that, first of all, we've been a big part in their demise as this species, so it's also our responsibility to help them out and help them to thrive once again on our beaches. Also, it can often tell us a lot about what's going on in the world and its little habitat. If it's thriving, it's doing well, we know that its habitat is a healthy one. If it is not, if its numbers are declining, then we need to take a look and see what's going on out there. If it's more than just the bird itself, but perhaps its habitat and the whole ecosystem out there, what's going on with that? What sort of measures may need to be taken? Is this a natural thing? If it's an unnatural thing.
The western snowy plover can be seen as an indicator species for California's native sand dune ecosystems. If the plovers are under the threat of extinction, then there may be many other less visible species that are also disappearing from California's shores. To stem this rising tide of extinction, the scientists and park rangers at Point Reyes National Seashore are conducting a wide array of efforts aimed at restoring and stabilizing the native dune habitat. The Snowy Plover Recovery Program is an integral part of these efforts to save California's legacy of native species.
We have a number of steps we take here at Point Reyes National Seashore to help protect the snowy plover. But when the breeding season starts in March, we put up what we call symbolic fencing around certain sections of the beach that we found that the plovers are, or traditional nesting habits, or they're currently nesting. Also, when we find a snowy plover nest, we'll put up what we call an exclosure. It's a 10 by 10 foot cage around the nest to help keep out predators. We also have leash laws for dogs, for visitors who bring their animals on the beach, as well as certain parts of the beach that we have closed off for pets on the beach. And in those areas, those are what we've called critical breeding habitats. So it's really important that visitors mind that fencing, stay out of those areas. We ask visitors that they walk closer to the water on the harder sand and view from the outside of the fencing and do it from a distance.